Today's question comes from Christian in Madrid, who asks, what's Google's position about continuing to recommend the HTTP vary user agent header for specific mobile websites after big players like Akamai said they don't cache the URLs that include it? Would you still recommend using it? Okay, this is a pretty detailed topic and it's pretty esoteric, so let's see if we can unpack it and try to explain what's going on there. So first off, what's caching? Well, if you ask for a web page and then you ask for the exact same web page, 3 seconds later, why do all the work to recompute what that web page might look like if you're doing a dynamic sort of URL when you could save that content and just return the same content back to users? Now, you might need to recompute that data once an hour or once a day or something like that, but once you've done the work to compute what a web page should look like, oftentimes you can cache it. And so in the case when you're hitting a web server, Facebook, Google, whatever, if we've computed the search results for, Britney Spears or something like that, and somebody else asks, what are the web results for Britney Spears, 1 millisecond later, we can usually just cache that and show them the same search results back or something along those lines. So caching is very helpful. It helps reduce the load on web servers. So now let's get into the problem that sometimes the user is doing the query from the desktop and sometimes the user is doing the query from a mobile site. Well, you'd hate to cache the desktop site and then when the user asks for the same page from a smartphone or something like that, for them to get a different, the desktop page back when they should get the smartphone page back. So there's a way that you can do that. You can handle caching by using the HTTP vary user agent header. And what that says is if you're a cache, whether you're on the local, the server side, Varnish, something like that, maybe you're the ISP, or whether you're a content delivery network, a CDN like Akamai, there are ways that you can specify what is safe to cache. And so if there's an HTTP header that says things can vary by user agent, so like Chrome versus, a mobile smartphone user agent, then the cache in theory can accommodate that and they can say, okay, well I'll save up to however many copies there are as I see of different user agents. So where does that lead to a problem? Well, there's a lot of different user agents. And I can certainly understand if somebody like Akamai would say, well, if there's 600 user agents, we don't want to save 600 copies of this page. So I think what Akamai has said is that they will not cache a page that uses the HTTP vary header if it's only by like user agent or something like that, because there can be so many different versions, they're worried about serving the wrong version or using up too much storage space. So given that, should people still continue to use the HTTP vary header? Well, I think the answer is yes, because there's still lots and lots of opportunities where server-side caches, ISP caches, all kinds of other caches could still make use of that information and could still do something kind of smart to avoid doing a lot of extra work or computation or something along those lines. So individual, content delivery networks might make a decision about how they would treat that specific header and whether they would do something differently, but it's still a good idea if you have a website to try to, send that information along so that the various caches between you and the user can try to do something smart. Because if you take that out completely, then they don't have any information and they just aren't able to handle that. So in general, in terms of, Google indexing, it's not apparent to us whether a URL can return different content based on the user agent. And so we actually do look at the HTTP vary header in order to help us assess whether a page might be targeted both to desktop and to mobile. So that's another reason to use it. And I would recommend that people continue to use it because if you do, then that can help us figure out, this particular URL can return different content to desktop and to mobile. So it's kind of a complicated issue. Everybody's trying to do their best. But I think we do still recommend that you continue to use the HTTP vary by user agent header if you're serving different content to desktop versus smartphone or something like that. That's a pretty technical webmaster video for today, but I hope it all makes sense. Thanks.